Hi, today we'll talk about UpToDate and its use in medicine and especially in training in medical students, residents, and in trainees in general. So the issue is that UpToDate now looks like this is the go-to app for every question in medicine. So I'll be conducting rounds and then I'll ask how to approach first-time seizure, and then the students like sneakily will just go, hey, UpToDate, how to treat first-time seizure? Or whatever he's asking about.
Excellent question. Let me tell you the latest updates.
Like, okay, that's the answer. And sometimes they will overdo it. They will say, hey, up to date, what to eat for dinner tonight?
The latest studies show that Mediterranean food is great for health. Go for it.
Okay. So is up to date the go-to app and will answer all of your questions in medicine? And what are the things that you will not go to up to date for? And how to build strong foundations in medicine and strengthen your knowledge even before going to UpToDate. We'll talk about all of those things. This is your neurologist, Dr. Omar Dennoun. All right, UpToDate is great. We have a platform that has all the information, all the up-to-date information, all the greatest and recent information about the studies, the clinical trials, and the things that are updated for now. So for somebody like me who is a specialist or consultant, I go to UpToDate to see what is the latest and greatest in my field at that moment, and that will be very helpful to get everything on one place. However, when you are a student, resident, when you are in your early training, there is a problem when you go out to UpToDate for that because when you go to ask UpToDate what is the recent and greatest information about this subject right now, you are missing a lot because you do not have enough foundations. You don't understand deep knowledge about this subject. For UpToDate to tell you what is the most recent clinical trial that happened right now in the treatment of new onset seizures or what to do with splenic rupture. So my advice to you is that as a student or resident or early on trainee, you should consider going into books and read book chapters that they will have very good coherent knowledge and way of giving you the information. So you will go to the book chapter, it will start with basic anatomy, it will go to physiology, it will go to pathophysiology, I will tell you the disease process, then you will have very strong foundation and good understanding of that, how things go, and then you will go to treatment, and at that point, if you have very good understanding and strong foundations, you can ask what is the most recent update or most recent clinical trial in that particular subject. So my advice to my trainees, my residents, my fellows, my medical student is that I strongly advise them to go read book chapters and read books so that they get strong foundation. And once they have very strong knowledge, they can go ask UpToDate for what is the latest and greatest. And that is my take on UpToDate and medical students and residents and trainees. Thank you so much. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel to get all the recent updates on the brain and nerves and other hacks of medicine.